true gunners on my side like Austin. It's like bullets when we prophesy, yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys, if it's beef, I let it fry. Spiritual war, this war ain't coming. Got spiritual gunners on my side like Austin. It's like bullets when we prophesy, yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys, if it's beef, I let it fry.
Beef, I let it cook, look. New man in Christ and I stay living by the book. Shook. Me, nah, don't get it misunderstood. Sword of the spirit, I'm good. When my angels ride out to your hood. Move the gospel, ain't moving a budge. Move the gospel, ain't moving a budge. Spiritual gunners with me, in the field, like Thierry. And I'm a G when demons OD. I speak the word so they fear me. I use the word to attack. Spiritual war with the gang. Got the armor, never lack. Faith playing at the back. Saving souls, I'm with GK. Slaying giants like I'm David. When I see man, I'ma save him. I say it simple, that's in layman's. Load up the tech. That spiritual weapon, I'm always protected. Put him in check.
I put them demons in check.
Spiritual war, this war ain't carnal. Spiritual gunners on my side like Austin. It's like bullets when we prophesy. Yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys. If it's beef, I let it fry. Spiritual war, this war ain't coming. Got spiritual gunners on my side like Austin. It's like bullets when we prophesy. Yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys. If it's beef, I let it fry.
Speaking tongues, my spirit, I stir it up. Yeah, I got a heart of a warrior. Got the buck on the back like a terrier. And he broke all the chains, now I'm merrier. Ooh, Mary is me. And they gon' hear cause I can't be discreet. Yeah, they gon' hear it, the gospel I preach. Concrete with conviction when I'm on the streets. Yeah.
This world is a jungle, but I'ma just live by the book. Like I'm Mowgli, watch us closely. This life sweet, we living like Zack and Cody. Born after the second Adam, I rock at the back, but he ain't Tony. I'm with the homies, don't we bring no phonies.
What is his is also mine.
So we prophesy, walk by faith and not by sight. I'm like Ian, always right.
Thomas party with the guys.
Spiritual war, this war ain't carnal. Spiritual gunners on my side like Austin. It's like bullets when we prophesy. Yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys. If it's beef, I let it fry. Spiritual war, this war ain't carnal. Spiritual gunners on my side like it's like bullets when we prophesy. Yeah, my life is by design. Gang, gang, I'm with the guys. If it's beef, I let it fry.
Where you go, I follow. You're with me every step of the way. Here in the struggle, your love's enough to wash it all away. On the third day, yeah, you rose up and you beat death once and for all. Once and for all.
Sometimes my mind is feeling hazy, but Lord, you always come and save me. God Almighty, my safety. You're my end, you're my new beginning. You're my home, the one I confide in. You're the very end.
till I met you, Lord. Oh, you gave your life so I won't fall apart. On the third day, yeah, you rose up and you beat death once and for all. Oh, once and for all. Yeah.
There's nobody like you. Oh, there's nobody like you, Jesus. No, there's never been nobody like you.
Nobody like Jesus. Hasn't billions of men and women lived on this planet? But why? Why are we convinced there's nobody like Jesus? Was he not merely a teacher, a prophet, an exegeter, an explainer? And yet we find ourselves in history wondering, is there anyone like Jesus? Who is this Jesus? This man from the Middle East who claims to be God. Is he God? Is he sinless? Is he perfection? Is he the once and for all sacrifice for humanity? Is he a man without fear? Did he become sin so that you and I might become right in our relationship with God? Is there nobody like Jesus? Did he die between two criminals and a crucifixion? 3 days later, did he rise again? Is the grave empty? Has he defeated death, hell, and the grave and sin itself? If so, there is nobody like Jesus.
Hello everyone, I would like to officially welcome all of you to Worship Night 2.0. This is going to be a short talk show on like how we joined the cell, how we started Bible studies and everything. So again, welcome and thank you for being here. To my left, we have Ugona and Nazo, and to my right, we have Victoria and Emmanuel. The first question goes to Ugona. Thank you for being here today. The question is, how did you join the cell? Like the first time you came for a Bible studies meeting, how was it like for you and what was the experience?
Oh, okay. So hello everyone. My name is Sizi. Well, I came to Ghana not quite a while ago. So I came to Ghana and I was looking for a church because it's always good to have somewhere where you can go and meditate on the word and be with Jesus. So my good friend Samuel told me that we should just take a chance and go to CYC. And I was like, okay, since I was looking for a church to go to and he had a place in mind, I followed him. And my friend Samuel, he won't just say, let's go for anything. If a place is not really up to standard or up to par, he won't suggest that. So fast forward, I went to the church and I noticed some of the things that the man of God was saying. I could relate to them. I mean, it wasn't just like going to a church where they talk, and you can't relate. I really enjoyed his services. I mean, sometimes he would preach and then he would make a joke and everyone would laugh, but we all got the message. We all got the picture of what he was trying to say. So that was how I started to join, because if the man of God, you know, is directed in a positive way, that means everyone in the church would follow suit. So my friend Samuel suggested that we join a cell. So since he had already suggested coming to church and I enjoyed that, I said, okay, since your first suggestion went as planned, I joined the cell. And that's how I managed to join the cell. And what has been keeping me in the cell is basically just like having you know, brothers and sisters from another mother and another father, because, I mean, they take care of you, you know, they push you, they make you do things you haven't done. So I think that's pretty much how I joined the circle.
Thank you very much. So, Nazo, how has your experience been ever since you joined the cell, and you got like a group of people where you can, you know, do Bible studies with, go to church together? How has it been like for you?
Hello everyone. For the people who don't know me, my name is Nazo, and ever since I joined, it's been very, very, it's an amazing experience, because it's like having an extended family where you guys all have the same mindsets, the same things. It's like having 11 players on the football court, you see, and you are among them or part of them. So it's been real, real amazing doing things together, especially when you all have the same mind. So, yeah.
Thank you. So, Victoria, what are some of the things you've learned from being in a cell? What are some of the things that you've, or maybe some of the changes that you've noticed in your life ever since you became a part of it?
Okay, thank you very much, Emefa. Since I came to CUIC, like, there have been so many changes in my life. I've had a lot of doubt in Christianity, but when I came here, I'm free now. Like, I understand almost everything about Christianity. At first, I doubted speaking in tongues, and like, it was so weird to me when I see a group of people speaking in that language. But now, by the grace of the Holy Spirit and through Mommy Olga, I can speak in tongues. Glory! And also, like, I've had so many doubts in church service that Sunday, including Sunday and Saturday worship, wearing of trousers to church, and a lot of stuff that I considered them to be sin. But now, through Pastor Chris and CUIC, I now have the good explanation, and I am convinced now. I have no doubts, and now I have the power and the ability to also discuss and talk over Christianity to my fellows. That's how it has helped me. Thank you.
Okay. Glory. Okay, so for Emmanuel, the same question. Like, ever since you joined SL, not necessarily the church, but like a group of Christians, how has it been for you, and what are some of the things that you've learned from it?
Well, ever since I joined SL, I could say it has been amazing, because from the very first day, I could observe the togetherness, the love, the bond, and everything that we share among each other. And since then, the people that I've been able to come in contact with, the cell members, everyone has become so close to me. I gain words of encouragement, words of faith. We share the world together. We live as one. We are one big family. Everyone relates with each other. We can call on each other when we need each other. We relate with each other when we have issues. And basically, everyone in the cell, all the cell members, have really been there for me and have helped to shape my life spiritually with the Word of God.
Tina, so please, would you like to share with us how you joined the cell? Like, what happened? What pushed you to be a part of it?
I think it started with my friend William. Whilst everyone had gone home, and as internationals who were staying back, he encouraged me to, let's go. Because Sunday, we really don't do anything. So I was like, okay, let's go, and we went. And I at least the first day, I was quite amazed at the youthfulness of the pastor, because normally the pastors, they have gray beard everywhere and like some mustache that extends to their ear, you know. But the guy was a young guy, and then he was relating with things that we kind of understand as young people. So I enjoyed myself. And then everybody's helping everybody grow. And it was a no-brainer. So, yeah, that's how I joined.
So was it difficult getting into church? Or it was like, oh, come, they easy, just follow.
I mean, if it's church, I can attend and run away the next day. But it wasn't difficult. He just told me to come. It's like somebody invites me to come for something that is free. And I said, okay, let's go. And I went. So it
wasn't okay, what about you, Uguna? Like, was it very difficult getting to church?
Actually, yes, it was very difficult because I don't normally, I believe even if you are home, anywhere, you can connect to God. I don't really believe in coming, but I understand that, you know, it goes a lot when you actually put that extra effort to come into church. And yeah, I mean, I feel like my spirit just chama, let's move. And then I moved.
Okay. Victoria, have you ever like had any experiences with like maybe there are certain questions that you have about Christianity that they probably got answered when you were a part of the cell? Like, what are some of the questions that you used to have?
I've had so many questions about Christianity. Because since childhood, I've been having teachings with the Adventists, and I was so confused about several things, like tongue speaking, as I said earlier, going to church Saturdays, Sundays, wearing shoes to church. Do you get me? You know, some people, they don't take shoes inside the church, like they take it out and, okay. So those stuff, I was really confused about it. But when I came to Christ Embassy, by God's grace, now I understand everything verbatim. And also, as I said earlier, I have the ability to speak in tongues. At first, I was confused when I see people speaking in tongues, because I was taught non-fa things, seriously. Yes, I was taught non-fa things. But through Pastor Enoch and Pastor Chris, my cell leader, Sir Anne, and several of you, I've been able to understand several Christian doctrines that helped me so much. Thank you.
Thank you. So, the most important thing here is you have to be more serious when it comes to your Christianity. It's not necessarily about, let's say, Christ Embassy or about this denomination of church. Because whatever church you are going to, make sure you are participating and you are actually impacting lives in whatever you do, right? Okay. So, Emmanuel, share with us some of the things that you've done ever since you joined the cell that you think has helped.
Since I joined the cell, I have been more active in things of God. I've been in going to services, Bible studies, reading the Word of God, relating with people on things of God. So it has actually made me to participate more and to be serious more in things of God, because before I joined the cell, I was a Christian, right? I believed in God. But I just wasn't so active in my Christian life. So ever since I joined the cell, I've just been rejuvenated and I've become more active and practical in my Christian life.
Okay, thank you. So we are almost done with this session, but the last thing I'd like to do is, Uguna, what like advice do you have for people who, you know, have decided that, oh, they don't want to work on themselves when it comes to their Christianity, or people who are like being lukewarm when it comes to Christianity or when it comes to like their spirituality?
want. Yeah. So my can you hear me? Okay, yeah. So my advice would actually be the most important thing is always to follow your gut. By your gut, I mean you have to listen to your spirit, because if you think that you are the only one, or it's you against the world, it's not true. You know, I know that God has his arms wide open. All you just need to do is come closer to him. So my advice would just be, listen to your spirit, you know. It will guide you. And you also have to be with God, like put effort. If you put effort into God, God will put effort into you. And I think, yeah, because a lot of people are going through life feeling like they're alone. A lot of young people are depressed at the age of 12, 13, 14, because they think they're alone and they want to do everything on their own. So yeah, I think just know that you are not alone and put effort, you know, go to church and, like I said, walk with God and God will work on you. So yeah, that's my advice. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And Nazor, is there any advice you'd like to give?
I think everyone here knows there's a spiritual side to things. There are things that are way beyond our control and understanding. And most of the reasons you are doubting or afraid is because you have questions that no one has answered, you know. The logic that answered that question was when we went to school online. It wasn't the same as going to school and being around the people who are still schooling with you. So just ask more questions, get more answers, and then ultimately your spiritual size will grow, and then you become an ultimately a better person. So
thank you very much. And thank you very much for listening to us. This brings us to the end of our session.
Cold, and you don't wanna be really bold. Just wanna be alone. You're tired of doing this on your own. Yeah, let me tell you that there's someone greater, someone that proves that you really matter, someone that explains what's going on when everything feels like it's going wrong. Someone that'll be there for the seasons. Every new day feels like I'm getting old. It's been a minute since I lost control. Yeah, I'm so done with being the person I was. Just wanna be a reminder of love. Oh God, I messed up so many times, but I just wanna thank you. I know I kept it private right inside, but that never changed you. Always been here through the seasons, never left my side. You saw me falling fast, you didn't let me slide. You've been there through the seasons, from my losses to new lessons. Yeah, you've been so good. Yeah, I know you never left my side. My side, my side. I know you'd be there through the seasons. 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 Never will you miss. Seasons. Never will you miss.
back, I'm going straight for the loot. She want things like diamond chains and coupes. Almost lost my soul, had to fight for my life. Had to do everything just to make it right. Feeling like a renegade. Feeling like a renegade. Feeling like a renegade. Feeling like a renegade. Okay. I can hear them talk, they calling me insane. But I got God on my side, we don't play no games. No, he don't know. Only for God, we beat up the odds. They thought I would fall, call me insane. Now they know my name, and I'm steady too. Look at me now, I'm next to the ground. They're trying to surround, but when I was down, y'all weren't around. Feeling like a renegade. Feeling like a renegade. Like a renegade.
I've been an outcast since outcast was a thing. Yeah, I've been down, but then I just bounced back with a ring. Some people fall, but I really doubt that's ever me. I need Jesus, he took me out past where I thought I'd ever be. I thought I'd be a thing, I wasted my time, was out walking blind. So I never thought I'd see a thing, but he gave me vision on top of provision. So you'll never catch me settling, cause I seen the other side of the obedience. He took my past into an ingredient, now I see blessings raining like a
stadium.
A diamond from the pressure. I've been in the game for so long, I'm a professor. You get what you seek for the answers. Jesus, so I won't miss right at the buzzer. I just got some demons to ring, I got wrestled.
Straight off the bat, I wanna rip out the track, rip. Let's rip to the track, and I wanna stick to the facts, stick to the facts. I'm the seed of AB, never lack. We are the salt of the earth, and you know that we never look back.
Seed of AB, no smoke with me, no Trinity. That's free. I get one, it comes when I speak. That's 24/7, I ain't even weak. First, and then I plan. Comes to I, no bags. All things through Christ, I know I can. Blessings keep falling from my right hand. Left, right, left, right. And you know, so we're coming like an army. Dressed in khaki, ready to ride, so hand me the car key. And we don't play, we just praise, we don't do this partly. Ephesians 6:17, bro, they ain't a thing that can harm me. Salt of the earth, and you know that we're bringing that flavor. Grace on spill.
Team and with ABLB, that's my brother. We lie up the scene. Said I Came with the G's, my brother. I'm a clip. Put this light in my spirit, my brother. So I got this. I got this Rhapsody up in my pocket, my brother. So I got this light in my jeans.
It's a new day, new life, and I'm in a new rave. Oh, I'm in race. Double R's when we pull up in the place. Can't ghost, you're safe. Why? You pay the ransom. And this is real life, bro. It ain't a phantom. I've been abandoned, Christ is my rock. I sold all them seeds, so I'm reaping the crop. Man's calling the shots, things come when I want. Like, bro, I don't think that you're deep in. The word is something I'm deep in. That means even on a week.
Hello, everyone. Glory. Glory. Okay, so I hope everyone is excited to be here today. We are here for another 10 to 15 minutes. Just talk about the benefits of fellowship and the benefits of church, how their experiences have been and how their lives were before they became like very serious with their Christianity. Okay, so to my left, we have Ugona and Portia. And to my right, we have Michaela. And in Skak. So the first question will go to Ugona. The first question will go to Portia. Okay, so Portia, what do you think are the benefits of fellowship or fellowshipping together at least once a week?
Thank you very much, sir, for this opportunity. Thank you very much, MFA. God richly bless you. So, one of the benefits of going to church is that. So, one of the benefits of going to church is that church enables us to see things from different perspectives. In the sense that what may seem possible to you wouldn't seem possible to someone else. And as we all know, Pastor has been telling us that we are in charge of our body, so we should have faith and believe in ourselves. So let's take this example. You are not well, your head is aching you, or your whole body is weak, and you'll be like, oh, because my head is aching me, I won't go to church, and you'll be giving so many excuses. No, it shouldn't be like that. You should take charge of your body and have faith. Everything will be okay. Because when you go to church, you wouldn't know what the pastor would preach about, and you'll just be healed. You'll just be filled by the Holy Spirit.
So what you're saying is faith heals. Thank you. So let's go to Michaela. Michaela, what do you think are the benefits of fellowship?
Okay, so thank you. And then I've learned a lot from fellowshipping with God. And then I learned that God's love is the greatest. And then, so I want to cite an example, because there are days I can just be sad. Like, nothing is wrong, I'm just sad. But then since I started fellowshipping with God, get it. I'm like, nah, Holy Spirit is my, like, he's my comforter, he's my helper. If there's something wrong with me, I can just pray, I can go to him. Than being sad for like no reason. And then I've learned not to rely on people, because people will fail you, yes. And then if you rely on people too much, like anything that you tell them or something, like it goes out. But then Holy Spirit is your helper. Like, after you talk to him, he gives you an answer. So you can go to him when you're sad, in times of trouble, when there's something wrong with you, and you get an answer. Thank you.
So what you're saying is, you find joy something with God. You find joy in like the Holy Spirit, which means that in Christ there's nothing like depression, right?
Okay. There's nothing like depression.
So you're saying in Christ there's nothing like oh, I have anxiety or I have mental disorders.
You don't have in Christ. Holy Spirit is your joy.
Yes. Okay. So
Firstly, I would like to say thank you for this opportunity. Very ethical when it comes to the church. Growing up, I've always been going to church just because it's compulsory. Like, you can't be in the house. We just go. Then along the line, I lost it somewhere. Then after that, after I lost it, I tried to regain it back without God.
You tried to regain?
I tried to retrace my steps without God. It was working, but it was not working. My mom, because she's like my spiritual head, because she has always been fasting and praying on my case that I must come back to God. I must come back to God. So, like, some period, she sat me down and she spoke to me about God all over again. And it's like, I did not even know him all this while I've been going to church. To cut the long story short, after everything, I'm on track now. Forget my appearance, so Christianity is a personal relationship. Like, it's like a father to son. You need to know that, like, the way I relate with God is different from the way you would relate with God. So, the benefits of going to church generally, let me just give you one of the benefits. There are opportunities in the house of God, like job opportunities. I know lots of people that have gotten scholarships, have gotten good jobs, just because they went to church. And there were people that, because in the house of God, there are people that are always willing to help you. Job opportunities, like you have opportunities that you can't get outside. That is like one of the main hints of going to church. Another thing is, when you are going to church, you don't go to church, don't have that mind of that they are forcing you to go to church. You just go to church to just make them be okay. See, when you are going to church, have an expectancy, like hold God to ransom, that in this service, oh, see, this is what I want. And try God and see. Try God and see. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. Okay, so you spoke about something. You spoke about personal relationship with God, right? That's one of the most important things. Because we know there are a lot of people that go to church, they don't have a personal relationship with God. They are just going because, oh, my friends are going. Or their motive for going to church is not to fellowship with God. So, Michaela, would you like to talk a bit about your personal relationship with God and how you've developed it?
Okay, so personal relationship with God. Mine. So this is me. I'm like, my mom goes to church. Okay, I go to church with her. Every Sunday I wake up, I know I'm supposed to go. But I'll force myself to sleep because people of my age are not going. Why am I supposed to go with my mother? And I sleep. She'll come and make noise. And I'm like, okay, let me go. Else people will ask, where's your daughter? I'll go. This woman now will come and follow me. Come and sit by me. Hey, me too, I don't understand anything they're talking about. I have to go. Respect, yes. Then in the course of it, I'm still not listening to anything going on. I'm not listening. I'm going because my mother said I should go to church. That was it first. But then I got to realize that I'm not going to church because of her. I have to have a purpose for going to church. I have to develop a passion for going to church. Like, yes, this is what you want to do in church. This is what you want to do for God. Like, you have a purpose for living. So you have to go to church. Like, you have to pray. Praise God. Sorry. Like, you are not alive because you are alive. Like, you get it. And I'm like, okay, I began to understand. Now when I wake up, I'm like, okay, 5 minutes, let me just say a short prayer. Because at least I'll wake up and be like, no, I don't want to pray. Then something dawns on me, like, why are you not praying? Like, people are sick. people are dying, like there are things wrong with people, and then you are here like giving an excuse that I don't want to pray, then I'm back on track. Then I'm like, okay, let's go on. I got time. I started going to church like more often. Then I joined the church and I'm like, okay, like let's go on. I can do this. Then I'm like, okay, we can, like, so like I don't see why someone would just get up like just Sunday and be like, I'm not going to church. Why? Like, you have to have a purpose, like, for serving God. You have to do something for God, because He didn't just create you. Yet.
Thank you, Michaela. Thank you. Portia, would you like to share with us your personal relationship with God?
Okay, so my personal relationship with God.
And so, how you've developed it.
Okay, so before Academic City, I wasn't really regular at church, not because my mom or my dad doesn't force me to go or something. They do, but sometimes I don't just feel like going to church. Not that I didn't know the relevance of going to church, but there is nothing that was moving me to go to church or something. But now, when I came to Academic City, my first time in CYC, I felt this joy. I felt this joy in me that I don't think something will just be like, Portia, you shouldn't go to church again, because I felt the vibe of going to church, and I now know the relevance of going. Because in all things, we just have to put God first. Thank you.
Uguna, could you please give any advice or word that you think about developing your personal relationship with God first? Because one thing I realized is when you have this personal relationship with God, right, it gives you this hunger to want more. So when you step into any place or when you step into the church, you want to go because you have a personal relationship with God and you want to learn more, right? So could you give any advice to people that would think, oh, I pray in my room, so it's fine, or oh, I think gospel, or I do this, so it's fine. Yeah,
so developing your personal relationship with God is actually very important, because there's a cliche that everyone thinks that, you know, you have to go to God, oh Heavenly Father, and you must speak the plenty English. Well, it's actually, God actually looks at your heart. So you personally, you know the type of person you are. Everybody's unique for a reason. And when you are trying to develop a personal relationship, you shouldn't compare or try to make your relationship with God with the next man. So with developing your personal relationship, you just have to know the type of person you are and also speak to God. Because it's when you talk to God, you will know the things that really work for you. You know, some people, they like to meditate. Some people, they like to speak in tongues. So it's best for you to have your personal relationship, because it will help you speak to God and hear Him better. So yeah, that's why it's good to.
Thank you so much, Guna. All too soon, we've come to the end of today's talk show. And just to prove that regular attendance or fellowship with God is biblical, I'll take Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, which says, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. So God is saying that in preparation for His next coming, it's very important that we do fellowship with Him together, because it's the body of Christ, and we have to take it seriously. Thank you so much for having us, and yeah, we are done.
close on Sunday. You my Chick-fil-A. Close on Sunday. You my Chick-fil-A. Hold the selfies. Put the gram away. Get your family. Y'all hold hands and pray. When you got daughters, always keep them safe. Watch out for vipers. Don't let them indoctrinate. Closed on Sunday. You my Chick-fil-A. You're my number one. With the lemonade. Raise our sons. Train them in the faith. Through temptations. Make sure they're wide awake. Follow Jesus. Listen and obey. No more living for the culture. We nobody's slave. Stand up for my home. Even if I take this walk alone, I bow down to the King upon the throne. My life is his. I'm no longer my own. I pray to God that he'll strengthen my hand. They will think twice stepping onto my land. Try me and you will see that I ain't playing.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. Oh God, to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. And you have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, flies till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Still your love fought for me, yeah, and you have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me, and you have been so, so kind.
Yeah. thought that filled his heart every morning, noon, and night. He loved me when I didn't care and was patient till I came running back into his arms. Look how he turned my life around, gave me a shining star, his glory to reveal. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. Da 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 da. How good he is, just look at me. He took me from the miry clay, set my foot upon the rock. I'm standing in his righteousness. He took away my sin and shame, gave me a brand new name. He's beloved and he redeemed. Look how he turned my life around, gave me a shining light, his glory to reveal. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. Worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. And I will worship him forever, love him forever. God is too good, oh. This God is too good, oh. This God is too good, oh. Jesus, you're too good, oh. Jesus, you're too good, oh. Don't deserve it, but I'm grateful. I don't deserve it, but you love me anyway. I'll worship you forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. Look what you've done for me. See how you set me free, how you wash me your righteousness. I don't understand, but I'm grateful. I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. And I will worship him forever, love him forever, because this God is too good, oh. We love you, Lord. You're too much, oh.
sur toi est répandu. Si l'offrande de mon cœur, tout est pour toi, Jésus.
Father, I've known you as a friend. is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. It's running after me. Lay down and surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. It's running after me. Running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
Toujours aimé, sans relâcher ton amour, ne m'abandonne pas. Bien que je sois imparfaite, tu es avec moi. Rien ne pourra changer ton amour pour moi.
Toi,
oh,
mountaintop, I can see so clear what it's all about. So stay by my side when the sun goes down. Don't wanna forget how I feel right now. And you are Jaira, you are enough. Jaira, you are enough.
Okay. First of all, I'd like to greet everybody here. Okay, can you guys hear me? Can you hear me? Can you please increase the sound on the pin mic? Can you guys hear me now? Is it clear? You're saying no, but you're answering my question and saying no. Can you hear me now? Is it clear? Still not clear. But you're saying no when I ask the question. Anyways, whilst they are working on the sound, first of all, I would like to invite everyone here. Thank you so much for coming out today. It's a pleasure seeing you guys here. I hope you've enjoyed the event so far. For some of you, we came very early. We didn't start quite on time. But can you hear me? You can hear me now. Right. So I was saying, we didn't start quite on time, so apologies for that. Okay. can all hear me now.
Sorry about that. Anyways, so this is Worship Night 2.0. I'm just going to give a brief explanation on what it is we're actually doing here and why. Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me? Okay. I'm going to give a brief explanation of what it is we're doing here and why we're doing it and how you can actually participate. Okay, so this is Worship Night, and it's primarily a Christian event. So we're going to talk about, first of all, who a Christian is and why we worship. So it's a very short one, and then we get back into the worship. Okay, so I'm going to give my life examples, because that's the best thing I know. It's my own life, so I'll use that. So the main reason why we had this event, Worship Night, is because, casting my mind back to about 3-4 years ago, when I finished high school, SHS, and I was coming to uni. You know, I was brought up in a Christian home, but like, I'm sure like most of us, I didn't really have a relationship with God per se. I just had my parents go to church, I go to church with them, and we are, you know, Christians. So like on paper, if they ask me, what's your religion? I'll write Christian. But I didn't really have a relationship with the God I claimed to serve. Okay. So that resulted in like, a double life in a sense, because my parents are very strict, you know, they are very staunch Christians, you know, they have like Christian values and they don't condone certain things. So I used to live a double life. So I remember when I came to uni, like my first year, freshman year, I'll go to church on Sunday with my parents, but like I can be in the club Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and probably Friday as well. Just, you know, exploring everything. One major reason was because, like I said, from a Christian home, my parents, when I was at home, before I came to uni, before the liberty, I couldn't really do what I wanted to do. Like, for instance, in my house, you can't come back after 9 p.m. and expect peace. Like, just when I come back at 9 p.m., prepare your points for war, because there's war that day. That's even if you enter the house. That's the first wahala, is to enter the house. The second one is defend yourself. And that stress can last 1 month. That one day, they will never stop talking about it till a month's time. So, so I came to uni. I finally had freedom. I can go out whenever I like, and come back wherever I like, go wherever I like, do whatever I like. No one's gonna ask me any question. So, like I said, I didn't have a relationship with God. So most of the church going was just for formality's sake, but now I have the choice. So I was like, you know what, I've gone to church for my whole life, the beginning part of my life, so it's time for me to do the other things. I'm sure you get what I'm saying. So I was all over the place, almost not all, because even then I didn't really like to like a very crowded environment. But then for most parties, most, you know, events, I'll be there. I noticed one thing. Whilst in those spaces, I never really felt like I belong there. I don't even get what I'm saying. Like, you can go for the party. Everyone else is seemingly having fun. You smile. Yeah, you take some of the alcohol. It depends on how strong your parents' training was. You might also add a puff, you know, like a cigar. As for me, I was afraid of that because my grandfather really made me afraid of smoking. So that one was not even about Christ. It was fear. So I didn't venture into that. But, you know, I was doing everything. And I was like, okay. They said it was going to be like some wonderful experience, like ecstatic. But, you know, like, when you're high, okay, I don't know. I hear there are different degrees. So I don't think I've gone that far. But the far that I know about, it lasts for a very short while. I don't know if, like, it's not long. And it's not fulfilling. Even when you're done, you regret it. Like, what did I just do? Like, do you get? So I always wanted that feeling of ecstasy that lasted for like 5 minutes, 10 minutes. I wanted it to stay. Do you get? Like, to be an environment and something I can quicken at any time. I don't need any drink or smoke or something to create that kind of environment. So I'm just trying to let you see that I had a certain desire in my heart. Now, secondly, from last worship night, I also spoke about this, how at that point in my life, I didn't really have, I had never really experienced unconditional love, like love that you do not deserve. I don't even get my point. Like, you know that this person, like, I don't deserve this person's, you know, attention. I don't deserve this person's love. So in that space, you could have seen me smiling most of the time. I can be out and I'm like, I'm bawling, I'm dancing and all that, but I wasn't really joyful inside. I'm sure most of you, some people might resonate with this. You know, like, we put up a front in front of everyone, make everybody think we are okay, but we really aren't. You are in this party, you are just here because it's like the cool kids go here, but you really don't feel like that's where you're supposed to be. I've been in that position so many times. I wouldn't say I was trying to fit in per se. I just felt like it was an obligation in a sense, you know? Because let's say I have a group of friends, we're all going out. These are my guys, so let's go. I mean, my guys, everyone's taking a drink. Why just sit idle? Okay, it's a drink. The Bible never said you can't drink. Then I was, you know, defending this one. The Bible never said you can't drink. What it says is don't get drunk. But the funny thing about alcohol is if you stay close to it for long enough, you get tipsy. Like, you will not even realize before you are gone. Okay, for me personally, I don't think you realize before. If you keep on sticking around, it will normalize. So during the lockdown season, the whole COVID period, for some of you, I don't know how COVID was like for you. I know for some people it was tragic, but for me, I kind of thank God for that season because my whole world stopped, you know? Like, I had time to really think about my life. Do you get my point? Like, to decide, okay, where are you going right now? Like, are you a Christian? Are you not a Christian? Like, what are you doing with your life? So I remember, like some of you, I had friends that invited me to church. And I mean, it was online at the time because it was COVID, so I didn't have to go anywhere. And all I was doing in my life that back then was Netflix and sleep and eat. Like, Netflix, sleep, eat, Netflix, sleep, eat. So I was like, okay, it's not a big, finally, something different. So let's see. Because I've been hearing about this church even before lockdown, but I was like, you know what, let's just join the live stream. So I joined the live stream, and for the first time, I actually felt the power of God. You know, I'd been in churches that seemingly had the power of God present, but I never really experienced it for myself. And I feel like that was really the main issue for me in my Christianity, because everything was they say. I never had, I have experienced. I don't know if you get my point. So after that experience, I was like, whoa. That experience was like way better than every other thing that got me ecstatic, you know. And it wasn't hard. It was just by worshiping. And that's the reason why I love worship so much. And that's the main reason why we are doing worship nights. Because I understand that until you actually experience God for yourself, you might not, it will be hard to live the Christian life. I don't get my point. Because you are doing things because they say they should. But I noticed after I experienced God, I was doing things because I want to. It was no longer I must. It was I want to. And that was the changing point for me. It was so, I mean, I realized life in Christ wasn't so hard once you've actually met Christ in an experience. So today, we are trying to present to you the Christ that we are talking about experientially. And I mean, as we all know, Jesus Christ, the person, the human being, died over 2,000 years ago. He died to save our sins, all of that. I'm not even here to talk about that today. But Jesus Christ died for us. And he, as a physical person, is no longer here with us. Right? Like, if I ask you, where's Jesus? You can't point a physical person that this is Jesus. But the Bible lets us know that Jesus is here with us through the person of the Holy Spirit. And that is actually the person we fellowship with when we are worshiping. When you are in worship, when you pray, that environment, that feeling is the presence of the Holy Spirit. And that's really what I want you to experience today. And this is the advice I have for you before we continue. You might have a preconceived notion about Christianity. I know a lot of people said this. Even I used to accuse people of this, that most Christians are hypocrites, all of that. I was once the hypocrite. And I understand that I am no longer a hypocrite because I have actually met Christ. I've actually experienced the Holy Spirit. So if you feel like you are that hypocrite, what I want to tell you is, today, drop everything you think you know, everything you've done before, and just bask in the presence. Just follow us in the worship. Even if you don't know the song, just hum. Worship is an intimate thing. It's between you and God. So I know there's a lot of people sitting here, but just focus on you and your God. Do you get my point? It doesn't matter if you sinned yesterday or 2 minutes ago or 5 hours ago. The beautiful thing is the Bible tells us that there's Jesus Christ who's our advocate. The whole reason why Jesus came to die is because we couldn't live rightly on our own, because we're born with the nature of sin. If you're arguing with me, the question I like to ask people when they argue on this, like with the sin nature, is whoever taught you how to lie? Like lying. Who sat you down and explained how to lie to you? How to say something that is not true and convince people to believe it? I personally think every single person just knew how to lie. And that shows that it's from within you. So what I'm here to say is, if you feel like you're in an addiction or you have a sin issue or whatever your problem is, it's actually not your fault. It is the way the natural man is. He cannot do right in God's eyes except he's met God. Do you get? So the solution to that problem is the God I'm trying to present to you today. So just drop all your experiences. If you think you are worthy, if you are not worthy, just take my word for it, that you are worthy. You are also loved by God, because God created you and he loves every single one of us. Every single one of us is a child of God and is supposed to experience the blessings of God. So from whatever church you are from, if if you go to church with us, if you don't go to church, even if you are Muslim and you are here and you feel like you want to experience this God thing we are talking about, then just join us in worship. Just sing the songs if you can. Just hum it along. You can lift up your hands, you can kneel down, you can lie down, however you want to express yourself. That's why we don't really have like a very serious set here, because we don't want you to think it's a performance. This set represents our relationship with God, which is intimate. So just join us as we are worshiping our God, because I'll be worshiping and I'll forget that you're here. And I'll advise you to do the same thing. So as we start, I'm going to say a little prayer. Dear Holy Spirit, thank you so much for creating this opportunity for each and every single one of us to experience your presence. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Father, every single heart here that desires to encounter you, Holy Spirit, I thank you for touching their lives. I thank you for showing yourself to your ministration. I thank you for creating a bond with them and helping them experience what I experienced in that very first Numaska night in my room. I pray for an even better experience, because I've had many better ones since then, that they can connect to you and get to know you like I know you. In Jesus' name, amen. So, I'm going to start my worship. Now, this is a song from my heart. So, you might not know the lyrics, but you can sing yours too. You can sing your song to God. Whatever you want to say is an instrumental. We can just all sing what we want to say on it. If you speak in tongues and you want to speak in tongues, you can do that. Feel free. So, can you increase the volume a little bit for me, for the song, not the mic? I adore you, yeah.
Okay. I don't know.
that was for you. That was so wonderful for me. Well, we're going to continue with the worship now. And the next song is by Melody. She's singing Thine is the Kingdom.
The power, the glory. William is leading us to the next song. Hallowed be your name.
Hallowed be your name. are taking our next song, Amazing God.
You're amazing God, you are. amazing, amazing God you are.
Amazing, amazing, Jesus, you're amazing, amazing, amazing.
Amazing God you are.
Amazing, amazing, Jesus, you're amazing, amazing, amazing.
Amazing God you are.
Amazing, amazing, Jesus, you're amazing, amazing, amazing.
So, thank you all for coming to today's worship night. We have come to the end of today. If to today's event you have reconnected with God, or you want to give your life to Christ, maybe you're not a Christian, maybe you've been, you know, you haven't been living right, you want to rededicate your life to God, you want to give your life to Christ, please come forward and let's see. Okay. Going one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, okay, ten. All right. So I assume everyone here is already Christian. Also, you are cordially invited to our church service tomorrow at UPSA Auditorium. First service is 9 a.m. Second service is 12 p.m. There'll be a bus. If you're on Academic City campus, there's a bus that takes us to church every Sunday. So it'll be here by 9. Actually, before 9, like 8:30. So we can get to service by 9. And then for second service, it'll be here by 11:30. So you are cordially invited. If you'd like to come to church, you can just let one of the ushers know that you'd like to come with us so we can save a seat for you in the bus. Okay, so let's say a closing prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time in your presence. We thank you for a successful event. We thank you that you ministered to the hearts of everyone that was here and you had fellowship with them. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for greater times ahead. In Jesus' name I pray, thanksgiving. Amen. Okay, so thank you all for coming. God bless you. Bye.
Like, this is what your life like. Try to live the life right. People really know you push your buttons like type right. This is like a movie, but it's really very lifelike. Every single night, right? Every single fight, right? I was looking at the gram and I don't even like lights. I was screaming at my daddy, told me it ain't Christ-like. I was screaming at the referee, just like Mike. Looking for a bright light. Seagull, what your life like? Riding on a white bike, feeling like a sight fight. Pressing on a gas, supernova for a night light. Screaming at my dad and he told me it ain't Christ-like. But nobody never tell you when you're being like Christ. Only ever seeing me, only when they need me. Like if Tyler Perry made a movie for BET, searching for a deity. Man, it's really life-like, everything in my life. Arguing with my dad and he said it ain't Christ-like. Man, all doing good. I try to talk to my dad, get him some advice. He starts spazzing on me. I start spazzing back. He said, they ain't Christ-like. I said, ah!
Englisch als Weltsprache meistern.